Malolele, I'm Joe Naufahu, and this is my world.
I'm the youngest in my family, family of five. I got two older brothers, two older sisters.
My brothers and my sisters, my mum and my dad, and my little ones, I couldn't do without those guys.
Boom, here. Yeah.
This is taking you back now to when I was my first year at varsity at Auckland University. So on orientation day, mum came with me. I had to line up and get my books and all that, and mum was like, no, Joseph, this is not the line for the paper, for the business. Come over here, this one. And I was standing there like, oh. And my mates all there, oh, Joe came with his mum.
I just can't seem to get away from this boy. Everywhere he goes, I have to go, because he was my baby.
I ended up getting a contract to play in the UK, and, you know, mum and dad were like, oh, well, we might as well go to Tonga now. Sandler's gone. And when they went to Tonga, they set up a steakhouse in Tonga, and they called it Joe Boy's.
Joe Boy's Steakhouse.
Yeah.
Right in the middle of town.
Do you play rugby?
Eli Fasalili. I'm the most promising since Luke McAllister, so they reckon.
Oh, Jesus!
If anything goes wrong with any of the deliveries, there'll be problems.
We're partners for life, Result!
When he got into the Game of Thrones, and he said to me, oh, I got to the Game of Thrones. And I said, what Game of Thrones? He said, what is it? He said, oh, it's a program on TV. And then I said,
thought it was a game show.
Every time we talk to somebody, they said, oh, my God.
I was like, it's not a board game, Dad.
It's just me, myself, and I. Solo ride.
I play the leader of the Dothraki.
Yeah.
Get to ride a horse, which was an interesting experience because I couldn't ride a horse before. You get the audition piece, horse riding experience. Yes. Does that include merry-go-rounds at Rainbow's Den? Yeah, I'll take that. And I was lucky enough, one of the gang at Ludus is pretty good on the horse. So I went out with them and, you know, we did a few horse riding lessons and it was good to be confident on the horse, you know, because I was able to, you know, do those pusiki ones and just pretend that I was, you know, the man in the cart, you know. So, it was interesting working with horses, man. And I'm not eating them like at the feasts that my dad's family have sometimes. How's, you know, in between tastes? Hey, is that the Frankie eating the horse now? What's going on there?
Yeah, vos suck.
Learning a language that is completely fabricated and having to learn, you know, your partner's lines or the person you're acting opposite, because I could be saying mine and then if I don't know what she's saying or he's saying, then I'm just going to be doing the old cardboard, you know? So I had to learn it so well that if the director gave you some action or some direction, you had to know what he was pinpointing because he didn't learn the lines. He just spoke in English. He was like, okay, when you say you're gonna slit that throat, and you're like, oh, slit the throat was, yeah. So it was a mean challenge, like amazing experience, massive production. The scale was huge. So this is Kalmana Gardens in Herne Bay. It's a place that I like to come and give a hand, help out with my mum. My mum and I come out here. Mum loves gardening, so it's a really cool place for us to chill and spend some mother-son time.
I always have a love of gardening. We all grew up in Samoa. My mother grew every vegetable you could dream of having. We had watermelons, we had sugar cane. Oh.
Doing any work, Mum, or what?
I'm just starting.
You need some goat?
Yeah.
yeah, there's some up there. So a little bit of history about this place. Mum and her family, the 12 kids, moved into Trinity Street, which is probably one of the wealthiest spots in Herne Bay now. And it's about a stone's throw from here, but knew nothing about this place. We as kids grew up around here,
spend most of our time at Nana's house, barbecues and, you know, all the family gatherings, kongai and all that sort of stuff. So it's kind of a spiritual home for me and mum. And, you know, being part of giving back to the earth is very rewarding and it's lovely. Mum's doing a bit of weeding at the moment, so we got to get back into it, man.